Hi, welcome to Kausalvai's channel. This is the continuation video of marginal costing techniques. In the previous video, we have seen the basic concept of marginal costing techniques and formulas along with the marginal costing statement in detail. You can find the links in the description box. Also, you can find the links for various topics on various subjects as a playlist in the description box. In this video, we are going to see one numerical problem based on marginal costing techniques. So, please try to watch the complete video to get the clarity about this topic. Okay, so before we get into the video, guys, please subscribe my Kausalvai's channel and hit the bell icon to get the further notification of my new uploads. Now, let's get into the video. See the problem. From the following information relating to Mark Bros Limited, you are required to find out. The first one is PV ratio, that is profit volume ratio, then break even point, profit, margin of safety, volume of sales to earn a profit of rupees 6000, and then profit when sales are 75000. So these are the components they ask you to calculate in the first part with this information. The informations are sales 3000 units at 10 rupees each, so total 30,000 sales. Variable cost rupees 6 per unit, then fixed cost 8000. So these are the informations are there. With this informations they ask you to find out these components. The second part is, what is the new break even point if the selling price is reduced to 9 rupees. What is the selling price? 10 rupees each. Okay, selling price each unit 10 rupees. The second part is, they ask you to find out break even point if the selling price is reduced to 9 rupees. Okay, now we are going to see the solution. Look at the first part. In order to find out all these components, first we need to prepare marginal costing statement. As I told in the previous video, marginal costing statement is the important calculation that is the base for all these calculations. Okay, so first we need to prepare marginal costing statement. Let us see the calculation part. See, in the previous video, I have given the detailed explanation about marginal costing statement. See here, marginal costing statement is sales minus variable cost is equal to contribution. So after finding the contribution minus fixed cost, you will be getting either profit or loss. So this is marginal costing statement. So based on this statement, you can able to calculate all the components. Now let us see the calculation part of marginal costing statement. See the problem. Sales 3000 units at 10 rupees each. So 3000 into 10, 30,000 rupees. And variable cost 6 rupees per unit. So, how many units sold? 3000 units, no. So, 3000 into 6, 18,000 rupees variable cost. And then fixed cost, 8000 rupees. So, these are the information. Now, we can prepare marginal costing statement first. Look at the solution. The first step is preparing marginal costing statement. Start with sales. 3000 into 10 rupees each. 3000 units into 10, 30,000 rupees minus variable cost. Same 3000 into 6 rupees each, no. So 18,000. Sales minus variable cost is equal to contribution. So 12,000 contribution. Then minus fixed cost 8,000. Then you will be getting 4,000. So all these informations are there in the question. With that we have prepared marginal costing statement. Sales minus variable is equal to contribution. Contribution minus fixed is equal to profit. With this, we are going to find out all the components. See the problem? Let us see one by one. The first one is PV ratio, that is profit volume ratio. So, what is the formula for PV ratio? See the solution. The first component is PV ratio. Okay, what is the formula? Contribution by sales into 100. See the marginal costing statement. How much contribution? 30 minus 18, 12,000. No. So, 12,000 contribution divided by sales 30,000 into 100. See the calculation. 12,000 contribution divided by 30,000 sales into 100. You will be getting 40%. So, this is PV ratio, that is profit volume ratio. Look at the problem.
First, we have calculated PV ratio. The second one is break-even point. Okay, so break-even point can be calculated in units as well as in rupees. In this problem, we have unit price also, so that we can calculate break-even point in units as well as we can calculate break-even point in rupees. Let us see the solution. See the solution. Break-even point in units. What is the formula for that? Fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. Fixed cost is given in the problem, 8000. Okay, so in order to apply this formula, we need to calculate contribution per unit. So what is the formula for contribution per unit? See the formula. Contribution per unit is equal to selling price per unit minus variable cost per unit. Okay, see the question. Sales 3000 units at 10 rupees each. So this one is selling price per unit. And then variable cost rupees 6 per unit. So 10 rupees selling price per unit, 6 rupees variable cost per unit. Okay, see the solution. Selling price per unit 10 rupees minus variable cost per unit 6 rupees. So what is the difference? 10 minus 6 is equal to 4 rupees. Now you can apply the formula. Fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. So fixed cost how much? 8000 divided by contribution per unit 4 rupees. Okay, 8000 divided by 4, you will be getting 2000 units. Okay, so break even point in unit is 2000 units. Now you can calculate the same thing, break even point in rupees. Now we are going to calculate break even point in rupees. What is the formula for that? Fixed cost divided by PV ratio. Okay, so fixed cost is given in the problem itself, right? 8000. So 8000 divided by PV ratio. So what is PV ratio? See the first calculation. See the PV ratio calculation we have done in the first step. Okay, so how much PV ratio? 40%. See the solution. Apply 40% here. So 8000 fixed cost divided by PV ratio 40%, no. So 40 into 100. So you will be getting 20,000 rupees as break even point in rupees. Now see the question. Look at the problem. We have calculated PV ratio and break even point. So now we are going to calculate profit. Okay. So already we have calculated profit with the help of marginal costing statement. Now let us see the marginal costing statement for profit. See the solution. Already we have calculated profit in the marginal costing statement. So how much profit? 4000. See, the third component is calculation of profit, 4000 rupees. Look at the problem. Now we need to calculate fourth one, that is margin of safety. So what is the formula for margin of safety? Actual sales minus break even sales. Okay, so if we have actual sales and break even sales, this is the simple formula to find out margin of safety. Okay, so break even sales is, just now we calculated in the previous step, break even point in rupees. Break even point and break even sales both are same only. So how much? 20,000. Okay, break even sales 20,000. For actual sales, you can refer marginal costing statement. See the marginal costing statement. Sales how much? 3000 units into 10 rupees, 30,000. This is given in the problem itself. So 30,000 actual sales. See the solution. 30,000 actual sales minus break even sales 20,000. So what is the difference? 30 minus 20, 10,000. So this is margin of safety in rupees. So what is the formula for margin of safety in units? Same thing. Actual sales in units minus break even sales in units. See the marginal costing statement. So 3000 units, no, this is actual sales in units. Okay, see break even point in units. So break even point in units, how many units? 2000 units. So this one is break even sales in units. This one is actual sales in units. See the solution. Margin of safety in units, 3000 actual sales in units, 2000 break even sales in units. So 3000 minus 2000, 1000 units. Okay, so these are the two different calculation. One is margin of safety in rupees, another one is margin of safety in units. Okay, if we have actual sales and break even sales, This is the simple formula to find out margin of safety. If not, another option also is there. I'll explain now. See, another option is margin of safety in rupees. The formula is profit divided by PV ratio. So, what is profit? See the previous calculation. Profit is 4000. This one is actual profit. 4000. 4000 divided by PV ratio is 40%. No. See the first calculation. PV ratio is 40%. Apply the formula. 4000 profit divided by PV ratio 40%. So, 40 into 100, 10,000 rupees. This one is margin of safety in rupees. Same answer we got it. Okay, by applying this formula. The another one is margin of safety in units. The formula is profit divided by contribution per unit. What is the formula for contribution per unit? Selling price per unit minus variable cost per unit. Okay, so selling price 10 rupees, variable cost 6 rupees. 10 minus 6, 4 rupees. No. So, profit 4000 divided by 4 rupees contribution per unit. You will be getting 1000 units. This one is margin of safety in units. See the answer. Previous answer. 1000 units. 1000 units. Same thing only. So, this is the simple formula. If we have actual sales and break-even sales, you can apply this formula to find out margin of safety. Otherwise, you can apply this formula to find out the same answer. Now, see the problem. So far, we have calculated PV ratio, break-even point in units as well as in rupees, profit, margin of safety in units as well as in rupees. Now, we are going to calculate volume of sales to earn a profit of rupees 6000. See, in this component, they ask you to find out the volume of sales with a given profit. Okay, the required profit is given. In order to earn 6000 profit, what will be the volume of sales? That is the question. See the solution. The next one is required sales with a given profit. Profit is given in the question. With that, they ask you to find out the required sales in units as well as in rupees. What is the formula for required sales in units? Fixed cost plus profit, that is given profit, divided by contribution per unit. Okay. Fixed cost as per the problem 8000 rupees plus given profit is 6000. This is given in the problem. 8000 plus 6000 divided by contribution per unit 4 rupees. You will be getting 3500 units. So, this is required sales in order to earn 6000 profit. The same thing you can calculate in rupees. See, for rupees same formula. But instead of contribution per unit, you need to apply PV ratio. That's all. Fixed cost plus profit, given profit divided by PV ratio. So, fixed cost how much? 8000 plus given profit 6000. So, 8000 plus 6000 divided by PV ratio is 40%. So, 40 into 100, you will be getting rupees 35,000. So, this is required sales in order to earn 6000 profit. So, we have calculated required sales in units as well as in rupees. See the problem. In the first part, the last one is profit when sales are 75,000. Okay. So far, we have calculated all these components based on the given sales, 30,000 sales. But now, they are asking you to find out the profit when sales are 75,000 instead of 30,000. 75,000 sales, what will be the profit? That is the question. See the solution. We are going to find out profit when sales are 75,000. Okay. Very simple. In order to find out profit, we need to apply this formula. Contribution minus fixed cost. Okay. Fixed cost remains same. Whatever may be the volume of sales, fixed cost is going to be remain same. So that 8,000 will be the fixed cost. And we need to calculate contribution. So, what is the formula for contribution? We have 2-3 formulas. For this particular situation, this is the formula to find out the contribution. That is, contribution is equal to sales into PV ratio. Now, they have given revised sales. So, when sales are 75,000, no. So, take 75,000 given sales. 75,000 into what is the PV ratio according to the problem, given problem? 40% no, same PV ratio you can apply for this given sales. 75,000 into 40% 30,000. So this is contribution, new contribution. So contribution minus fixed cost is equal to profit. Okay, so contribution 30,000 minus the same fixed cost which is given in the problem, 8,000. So 30 minus 8 is equal to 22,000. So this is profit when sales are 75,000. Look at the problem. So far we have calculated all these components in the first part. See the second part. What is the new break-even point if the selling price is reduced to 9 rupees? Okay, in the first part, selling price how much? 10 rupees each. Okay, now they are going to reduce from 10 rupees to 9 rupees. Okay, so if they reduce from 10 to 9 rupees, what will be the break-even point? That is the question. Okay, see the solution. Here we are going to calculate new break-even point. Okay, now the new selling price is 9 rupees. So old selling price 10 rupees, no. Now they are reduced from 10 to 9 rupees. So new selling price is 9 rupees. So we are going to calculate new contribution per unit and new PV ratio. So these are the two important elements which is required to find out new break-even point in rupees as well as in units. Okay. So new selling price 9 rupees. So what will be the new contribution per unit? So what is the formula for contribution per unit? Selling price per unit minus variable cost per unit. So new selling price is 9 rupees minus there will be no change in variable cost. According to our problem, only they have changed selling price alone. So there is no change in variable cost. So you can take as it is. So selling price per unit minus variable cost per unit. 9 minus 6 is equal to 3 rupees. This is new contribution per unit. With this, you can calculate new PV ratio. So what is the formula for PV ratio? Again, same thing. Contribution divided by sales into 100. So new contribution is 3 rupees. No, 3 divided by new selling price 9 rupees. So 3 by 9 into 100. The answer is 33.33333%. So this is new PV ratio. With these two calculations, we can calculate break-even point in units as well as break-even point in rupees. See the first one, new break-even point in units. What is the formula? Fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. According to this calculation, okay, contribution per unit 3 rupees, no. Fixed cost remains same. Same fixed cost you can apply here also. 8,000 divided by 3 rupees is equal to 2,667 units. You can round up the figure. So 2,667 units. This is new break-even point in units. Now let us see new break-even point in rupees. See the calculation. Now we are going to calculate new break-even point in rupees. So what is the formula for that? Fixed cost divided by PV ratio. So fixed cost is given in the problem. 8,000 divided by new PV ratio is 33.3333%. So 33.333 into 100, you will be getting 24,000 rupees. So this is new break-even point in rupees. See the problem. We have calculated new break-even point in units as well as in rupees with the change in selling price to 9 rupees. Okay.
So guys, this is the way to solve numerical problem in marginal costing techniques. Okay, in the next video, we are going to see applications of marginal costing techniques, that is marginal costing in decision making. Okay, you can find all the links in the description box. Hope you like this video. Please hit the like, comment, subscribe and share with your friends. Thank you.